I'm at a point in my life where like everything I thought I knew about who I wanted to be, what I wanted to be, and how I wanted to do it was wrong. Was it not even wrong? Wrong is the wrong word, but it was misguided. And now I feel like every single aspect that I thought I knew as one way has been completely broken down. And it's really scary because your whole foundation has been shooketh. But it's also really empowering because like what I create from there can be anything.
The shit is functional, he do this every day until he comfortable. He going places, someone tell me where the fuck he come from though. Staring at the sky all day, cause he don't wanna die your way.
Hi, welcome to Mayowa's world. This video is so difficult because I'm trying to like be honest and not make a lot of edits and not make it about like it being really cool and like really catchy and really fun and just like telling as much as I can about myself while still preserving myself, but like being real. And that's hard when you make YouTube videos that's broadcasted to everybody. So I've taken a break for like a month or two of making videos, but I've been going through a really, really tough time with so much change. And I've just kind of had to take a step back and analyze my life. In terms of like the things that I'm going through at the moment, it's kind of funny because I feel like from like a career point of view, I'm doing really well, but I realized I put so much emphasis in my life on like doing well career or like financially that I've never really put that much thought into like how mentally and emotionally I'm doing. Like I've always equated success to having work, but I never thought of success past that. And so these past few months has been me attempting to have like a real conversation with myself and see like actually how I'm doing and allowing myself that space to not have to constantly work. Because I think I'm one of these people that like when I go through a hard time, it's really easy for me to dive into my work, but that doesn't actually solve the problem. It just keeps you going. Right? Like, and I think I'm in a position in my life now, or like I'm in a really privileged space where I can actually reflect on my mental state instead of having to be in survival mode. And so a lot of things I've been going through in these past few months is me switching from being in survival mode to trying to be in thrival mode. Not a word, but thriving, you know what I mean? Like I'm putting emphasis on not just like maintaining, but actually being able to like move past pain, if that's possible sometimes. Some of the things I've been dealing with is like, more so recently, a good friend of mine who I was very close with in college passed, and like, you just kind of realize how there's not really space to grieve and also be like a digital or online person. I've dealt with a lot of like, this past year has brought a lot of like really hard and painful experiences that I realized doesn't translate with social media. So if you do work that's in media and you're dealing with like a death or like a trauma, it's like, how do you balance the two? And I think the best thing for me was like kind of allowing myself the space to step back and just do nothing and cry and be okay with not having to constantly produce. And understanding what my pain looks like, because I don't think I really ever explored that in my life. I think I've grown up in a camp of like, you're going through pain, but like push through it. And like, you're going through pain, but like stay busy. And like, I get all of those things. And that's, like I said, naturally who I am. But I really wanted to be like, oh no, I'm going through pain. And like, what does that look like? Which I realized oscillates between like having a lot of rage about things and then feeling hopeless and then feeling optimistic and then feeling pessimistic. But instead of just like ignoring all my negative emotions, I've been trying to be like, hey, that exists as well. And the kind of work that I'm doing, I'm in a fellowship now, and it's allowed me that space to like process. And you don't realize how much processing is genuinely a privilege, to like step back and ask yourself like, how do I feel? And that's a really heavy question. So these past few months were really me asking myself that question, because in the winter time, it was the hardest time of my life. I was going through a lot of problems with my family and my dad, and it was really tough. So I never processed it. I think I just built a lot. Like I was like, make a lot of YouTube videos and like fight all the time and exercise all the time and like create content. And that was like really great for me at the time. But then I had a space where I realized like, I never asked myself how it actually made me feel. I never focused on my feelings. I was just focusing on producing. And those are very, very different kinds of emotional energies. So with me allowing myself to feel more, I feel like it allowed me to have like greater depth and empathy. And like, I just feel more balanced as a person. I also think as like a Black woman, we're like often in a very superwoman kind of role of like, we're gonna fix everything and we're gonna like help the world and we're gonna like, still I rise, like all these phrases, you know? But you realize that there's nothing wrong with not always like rising and not always saving and not always like wanting to move to the next level or whatever the next level is. Like a lot of times when things happen, it's nice to be able to be still and say like, oh, I'm not happy. And like, oh, that doesn't have to be solved by tomorrow. Like I can allow myself that space to really think about these things. And so that's kind of where I am in my life now, where I'm just like really thinking about things and asking myself what I want, which is like also questions that I think I told myself what I wanted. I'm like, you're gonna be successful, right? Like, but then I never questioned what my success looked like outside of career, which, hey man, that's a whole world. And I think a lot of it has to do with like this capitalistic society of like, go to the next step, go to the next level. And like, you think things work like this, but like life is really like this. Like growth and success is not linear. Nothing really is linear. Like sometimes it's like up and down, and that's good. But I guess life is more like a scatter plot. Like you have your up and downs, but like hopefully it's moving in a upward progression. But like the highs and the lows of what that looks like, take the wheel, Jesus. Intense. In other news, my birthday is tomorrow. I'm going to try and upload this video as raw as I can by tomorrow, because I'm just like, yo, let go of the edits and like let go of this concept of being perfect or seeming like your ideas are linear when like obviously, bitch, you like everywhere. So I'm gonna try and upload this by tomorrow. And then the 9th, the day after, I meet like Angela Merkel, who I don't know if you guys know who she is, but she's the German chancellor, which is also really intense and crazy to me, because I feel like I'm getting all these like career success amongst feeling really like insecure about who I am. And it's interesting how like from the outside, it looks as if like everything is like amazing and put together. And maybe in one element it is, like maybe in terms of career, it looks like that. But in terms of like how I'm feeling on the inside, girl, I'm rough on the inside. I'm feeling, I don't know, you know, like, am I worthy? Do I deserve this? Am I doing the right thing? Am I moving in the right direction? Like, I feel like, I don't know, like a globe that's just been shaken. And I think it's really important for me like document this for myself, but also to people that watch me, that like, yeah, my life is together in some aspects, but I really don't know what I'm doing. Like literally by the time I post this video, the next day I'm meeting Angela Merkel and like, I don't know what I'm doing in my life. Like who am I, right? So like on the outside, it's like, I know who I am and like I'm put together. But on the inside, girl, it's like, bah! It's like, it's intense. And yeah, like so many things that I like held as who I was has just completely fucking changed. Like I was fighting 5 days a week. I was kickboxing. That was like a big passion in my life. I don't kickbox anymore. I was like, I don't know. I was making videos like twice a week. I've made a video in 2 months. The things that I thought was like my identity, I'm realizing your identity is always shifting. And all you can really do is just like give space to that and like be honest. And I think like one thing I would like to have in my life, like at the end of my life, I would just like to say I lived an honest life. Like I don't want to be someone who is like lying. I don't know. And like obviously like everyone lies, I lie, but like I want to be able to curate my life to where like I don't have to lie. I think that's ideal. And yeah, that comes with me being really honest and like saying these kinds of videos, like, yeah, on the outside I look like I have my shit together, but on the inside, girl, we are it's rough. It's rough on the inside. But I have faith. I think honestly though, whenever you run towards a truth, no matter how messy or scary or condemned it is by society or even by yourself, I feel like what comes out on the other side will always be incredible. So I know right now, like, I have no clue where I'm going in my life. And it's funny because I made a video like 3 years ago called like, I don't know what I'm doing in my life. And I didn't know what I was doing in my life. But like everything I was talking about was like really career oriented. Like, I don't know what I'm doing. I like to make these things, but like, I don't know how it's gonna come together. And like now 3 years later, like everything I was liking to do in that time, I'm doing that as a career. But like emotionally or like spiritually or like where I wanna be, I don't know. And so I guess like life is kind of like, for me, it's like running, sprinting, hitting a wall and being like, oh wow, that wasn't what you thought it was. And then running in another direction, hitting a wall. And I think that's just how life is gonna be. And I think ultimately you wanna be able to like be honest about that and say openly like, hey, I'm right back where I was 3 years ago. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know, I was thinking about my life recently and I realized that sometimes like, if it feels like you're trying to get up and you're getting knocked down every time, like you're just getting knocked down, I think sometimes it's okay to just like stay down and wait for the punches to go and then to get back up. Like, I think I was trying really hard to like, oh no, I'm gonna fix it. And then I just felt like I was getting knocked down again. And I think I'm just like, all right, stay still. Like, if the ocean is moving you, if a lot of waves are coming, I don't really know why I'm trying to fight the wave versus just like allowing that wave to like move you. I don't know if I'm speaking in a way that you guys are following what I'm trying to say, but ultimately I feel like I'm allowing myself to experience feelings that I have never allowed myself to experience, because I have often in my life been doing everything financially and career driven. And I think asking myself like what kind of life I want to live, where do I want to live, who do I want to be, these are all like really good questions that I think I just was so focused on succeeding that I neglected a lot of other aspects of myself. And then the way that life just be throwing them dices, I've had to just confront them. Yeah, it's been rough. I'm not even gonna say like, but no. It's been rough. But it made me kind of sad that even with all of those things going on, I wasn't able to make YouTube videos, because I actually have a really, really, really nice YouTube community that typically makes me feel always better. Like, YouTube is one of the, I like YouTube better than making Instagram videos or posts or like Facebook. Because YouTube is like, you put in a body of work and then the way that people receive it is like really, really, really kind. And I really like my YouTube community. So every time I don't make YouTube videos, it makes me sad, because I'm like, oh fuck, this is actually a community that really supports you and really believes in the things that you're doing. And I should be doing that. I should be making these things. But these like shoulds will fuck you up, because you shouldn't be doing anything, right? Like, it's more of like how you want to engage. But what it made me realize is that like, I want to make realer content to like the things I'm going through, because the fact that like when I was going through this tough time for 2 months and I felt like I couldn't really show myself because I didn't want to put on like this like really happy-go-lucky or like really like, I don't know, bubbly persona, showed me that like I should be making content that's more true to my heart. So I'm realizing with these 2 months that I want to change the topics I discuss on my YouTube platform. I'm really open to like what y'all want to hear from me, because I do a lot of talks about hair and I love talking about my hair, because I think hair for Black people is like super spiritual, and like hair as like a form of knowledge is very deep. And I think even with me talking about hair on my YouTube channel, I like to think that I do it in a way that is also really like critical and like spiritual, because hair to me is spiritual. But I also want to talk about other things and like not feel like I'm cornered, like when I'm sad, I can't express myself. Like these 2 months away from YouTube made me realize, oh shit, you need to be making content that even if you're going through a horrible time, you don't feel like you can't show yourself, like your real self. So like things I wanted to focus more on is like talking more about colorism, talking more about being a black woman, talking more about feminism, maybe even talking about sexuality. I want to like talk actually too about fashion, or like do more fashion videos, because I feel like I'm churning out these looks. You know what I'm saying? Sadness in life, for some reason when I'm sad, my fashion sense, oh, wow, girl. Like sadness for me in fashion is just like, it's, you know, I don't want to toot my own horn, but like I just feel like I'm slaying the game as a sad person. So I want to like do more fashion videos, and I feel like fashion to me is like an armor, and it's a way of expressing yourself, but it also has like this lightness to it. So I want to try and change my content and like explore more, because I think sometimes when you make YouTube videos, if you feel like you're stuck within a genre, it can feel really, I don't know, like intense. And I feel like I actually have a really nice YouTube community that like regardless of what kind of content I make, I feel like people, like y'all still fuck with it and still show me like really good love. So I'm also curious like what kind of content y'all want me to make. I'm at a point in my life where like everything I thought I knew about who I wanted to be, what I wanted to be, and how I wanted to do it was wrong. Was it not even wrong? Wrong is the wrong word, but it was misguided. And now I feel like every single aspect that I thought I knew as one way has been completely broken down. And it's really scary because your whole foundation has been shooketh. But it's also really empowering because like what I create from there can be anything. So like also in terms of like the YouTube content I'm making, like I'm really in a position where I am absorbing everything. So if there's like something you want to see me talk about, let your girl know. I'm going to start creating content that feels authentic to myself, and I'm still going to be like doing the content that I feel like you guys also want to see from me, but I don't know. Expect some change, because like I have changed a lot in these 2 months, and I'm going to keep changing a lot throughout this whole like YouTube career space that I'm like living in. And I'm just really thankful that the people who like my stuff are actually really open-minded and encouraging and kind and cute. So it makes me want to keep coming back, because I think it would suck to have taken this like 2 month break and then come back and have like evil people like writing horrible things. Like I don't know how other YouTubers do it, to be honest. Like I can just speak for my YouTube community and like how I feel when I upload and create content, which is usually really happy. So if this video is interesting and you made it to the end, you are the real MVP. If y'all want to bombard my page, you know what I'm saying, and telling me happy birthday and stuff, like go on and do it. Yeah, but let's see if I can upload this before my birthday. So thank you for watching. Have a great day. Cheers. The shit is functional. He do this every day until he comfortable. He going places. Someone tell me where the fuck he